We begin with the D4 boys basketball finale. And if you look back to the start of the season, Southfield Christian may have been the defending champs, but two of their best players had transferred away. And then the team got off to a 2-5 start. Head coach Josh Baker got his Eagles to stretch their wings, winning 20 of their next 21. They figured it out. But Frankfort came into this contest with 21 wins of their own. They had an unbelievable Cinderella-like run through the postseason. Overtime wins in the districts and quarterfinals. Buzzer beater to win the regional title. And a one-point win over favored Wyoming Tri-Unity Christian in the semis. Panthers in their first ever state final. And that alone was reason to celebrate. What's even more amazing is Frankfort lost all five starters the year before, had a first-year head coach in Dan Loney, yet here they were, the senior big man Jack Resnick and the kiss off the glass. Now Southfield Christian is deep. Contributions come from a variety of guys. Noah Recker averaged 11 points a game during this season. He's crafty, bucket. The Eagles did a phenomenal job working the ball in transition. Case in point, Dejon Humphrey doing his Magic Johnson impression, Malcolm King the beneficiary, Southfield Christian out to a 10-point advantage. Frankfort was the fourth team from the Northwest Conference to make it to a championship game in the last 3 years. Senior Will Newbold stops and pops from the top of the arc. Well done, but the Panthers down 24-12 after the opener. So many weapons for Southfield Christian. Recker wreaking havoc. He contributed 10 points to the cause. The Panthers trailed heavily, but never took a possession off. Check out the junior Luke Hammond. Nice, but Frankfort trailed by 17. The Eagles shot 61% in the first half and have a talented squad coming back next year. The junior Humphrey to the rack, count it, and the contact. Game high 20 points. SC carried a 22-point lead into halftime. You just couldn't stop the Eagles. You could only hope to contain them. The senior John Sanders, the drive, gets the contested lay-in. Nice way to finish your high school career, young man. The biggest lead for Southfield Christian grew to 29. Frankfort had one guy in the third responsible for all of their scoring. The senior Newbold, 9 of his 17 in the third quarter from way downtown. Now, some of the Frankfort youngsters got some playing time, and any bucket energized the Panther faithful, but this was Eagle time. Humphrey with the bounce feed to a cutting Sanders. He finished with 19. Both teams didn't shoot great in the second half, but SC just wasn't going to be denied. Ramon Scruggs buries the team's 8th triple of the morning. Southfield Christian, back-to-back state champions. Frankfort falls 63-39. Eagles, 5th state title in the last 8 years.
TJ Kelly here with state champs, along with second-time state champion Dejon Humphreys from Southfield Christian. His second championship, you just talked about playing more of a major role for this team than you had, you know, when you were a freshman or sophomore. What does this mean to you to have, you know, a little bit of weight on your shoulders and being able to carry the Eagles?
I mean, it means everything to me. I mean, every challenge I take head on. And we lost a couple players, but I showcase like what I can do, what we all can do as a team, and just credit my teammates, man. They look at me for to get going, and they got my back. If I make a mistake, they tell me keep going, and they always give me the rhythm. So it's a blessing, man. It's a blessing.
Coach Baker talked about just having the cohesiveness of past guys that graduated from Southfield Christian, they've gone on to play in college. And when they come back, what kind of aura do they bring with them to say, hey, you guys need to win championships too? What are they telling you over the summer?
It's for sure expectation to keep the winning tradition going. And this is family, they're brothers, so they know that we work hard, and they tell us to continue to work hard, be a leader. Like Bryce, he texts us, keep going. HE texts us too. Brock comes back, so it's a family, it's a brotherhood, and they have high expectations, and we have high expectations for ourselves as well.
Obviously, next year, our expectations are to return to win another championship. You know, you lose some key guys. John Sanders came up huge this year.
Yeah.
What are you doing as a senior next year to really make sure that, you know, as the captain, to really bring everybody on board and say, this is what we do on 12 Mile?
Just keep the leadership, man. Tell everybody the experiences that I have, and just continue to be the leader, and push everybody every day in practice and be the example. Like, I can't be slacking when I'm in practice. I got to tell everybody when they slacking to keep it going, and just keep the tradition going, man. We're going to keep it rolling.
Why don't you talk about what Southfield, what you've done in the last 8 years for Southfield Christian and winning those five championships.
Yeah, it's been incredible. It's just been fun. You know, the biggest thing is just the amount of people that are involved in the program. I mean, we have my guy Tim Clark, you know, doing video for us from the school, and you have Chris Weber making sure I can get everything in on the computer, and people taping all over the state, and four and five coaches putting in hours and hours every single week, and parents putting in hundreds of hours, and the kids putting in all kinds of extra time, and Coach Donnan and the admin just putting in a ton of help to make our program great. So our trainer, like, people don't understand how big it is and how many people help.
Seems like it's almost like a part-time volunteer job, you know, to be a high school coach. You know, I'm on whatever level you're on, but then when you extend it to late March every year, and everyone's like, you know, this gig isn't going to be up at the first week of March. You know, we're going to keep on going, you know, because I'm with Southfield Christian. Obviously, a testament to you. What are some of the things that makes people actually say, you know what, this is something I want to be a part of?
Yeah, it's a great question. I think the biggest thing is they believe in our program. So you get like-minded people who say, hey, we want our young guys to a Christian education, follow after Christ, have that character. So I think that's the most rewarding thing, is all of our guys from Romulus and from SCS, they're like great, great people. They have great work ethics and great jobs and great careers and great families, and you know, they just, that the character and the discipline from sports is what carries over. So you get coaches who buy into that and believe in it, and then they get connected with guys, and then you can't leave because we got our eighth graders coming up, and you can't leave because you got to see Dejan through, and you got to see Noah through, and then we're going to have to see V through, you know. So those are the things that get coaches to buy in.
Sounds like a great job, you know. Hey, very, very convincing. Hey, congratulations on another championship. See you in 2020.